Hi, this is Lindsay, one of the co-hosts of Beauties and Headcanons. Thanks for listening to the following broadcast on Public House Media.
Hey, Choose Rise fans, Kim Meyer here. I wanted to extend an invite to you to join me in my healthy living accountability group, Together We Rise. It is there where we work on fitness, we work on nutrition, we work on positive mindsets, and supporting each other in the process of living a healthy, fulfilling life. In whatever season of life that you're in, everyone has the opportunity to live a healthier, more fulfilling life. So join me. Hit me up at choosetoriseup@gmail.com or check out choosetoriseup.com to learn more about how you can be a part of this amazing group and feel fulfilled and healthy for life. Mediocrity is a region bound by the north by compromise, on the south by indecision, on the east by past thinking, and on the west by lack of vision. Hello, welcome to Choose to Rise. I'm so glad you're here with me today. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you the first nugget from the book called An Enemy Called Average by John Mason. And I am super pumped about this book. My team is doing a book club on this here in December, the last month of 2019. And can we just pause there for a second and say, holy moly, how the heck did we get here to the end of 2019? Wow, the year has just flown by and it's been going so fast. And it's actually the very beginning of December. It happens to be December 2nd when I'm recording this. And it is, I can't believe it's already here. But this book, An Enemy Called Average, is how I'm going to end the year. And I hope that you end the year with it too. I'm going to share with you the first little nugget with you today and kind of talking a little bit about how we can overcome this enemy called average. It's a really thin book. It's full of tons of information. I have already skimmed through quite a bit of it and I've been in love with it. Our team started the book club today. So I'm super excited about that. And if you want to get the book yourself, you can go to the show notes or you can go right here in the live video. I've put it in the description and go ahead and grab the book. Like I said, it's a super simple read, but it's so powerful. And I just wanted to share with you just a little bit about this morning. So the book opens with this quote, "Mediocrity is a region bound on the north by compromise, on the south by indecision, on the east by past thinking, and on the west by lack of vision." And earlier in the month, year, whatever, I talked about how the most miserable people on the earth are the people that are stuck in indecision. If you can't make a choice, you're always second guessing yourself. You're always trying to figure out what the next thing is going to be. You're always like running in a lack of vision. You're stuck because you can't make a choice. But when you decide and you commit, that's when you're going to find success. And so I love this book that it's already starting out with such a meaningful piece right there. He said he started this book instead of waking up one morning to go to a speech. Instead of waking up and thinking, what time is it or where will I go? The first thought that came to his mind was what an enemy called average. And he knew that it was God giving him the title of his book. And he actually named the title of his speech that day, An Enemy Called Average. And this book was born. And so he's written this book in nugget style. And so that everyone can kind of process it in a little bit at a time and really kind of think things through. In Genesis 3:9, God asked Adam, "Where are you?" He is still asking this question of each of us today. And where are we going in regard to God's plan for our lives? Isn't that what we're all about here at Choose to Rise? Trying to figure out where we're supposed to be, what we're supposed to be doing, and how God is using us in this world? I would hope so, as he's given you tons of resources, tons of skills, tons of ability. And my prayer that as you read this book or as you're listening to Choose to Rise, that you figure out that calling, that you figure out that mission in your life, and that you are able to rise up out of your current situation to live the life that God created you for, that you're able to rise up and be the best version of yourself because you're supposed to be that way. And nugget one says your least favorite color should be beige. I'm going to read this section to you. It's super short. Exciting, innovating, transforming, productive, words that will never be associated with beige. Rather, beige implies lukewarmness, indifference, neutrality, attitudes no one wants to be around, right? I don't want to be around neutral people. Here's a great opportunity. Choose to be a person who is on the offensive, not the defensive. Never try to defend your present position or situation. People who live defensively never rise above average. Decide to be on the offensive, to take initiative. Lukewarm, indecisive people are never secure, regardless of their wealth, education, or position. Never let your quest for balance in life become an excuse for refusing the unique, productive, invading move God directs you to take. He always says, doesn't he always call us to do things that are not in our comfort zone? He calls us to do things that are bold. He calls us to do things that are unique to us. He calls us to do things that are going to make a difference in this world. And what we do in our life because of those things really matters. Like if we decide to take the initiative that he calls us to do, if we decide to answer the call, if we decide to do what he's asking us to do, big things can happen. And sometimes that can be scary. When you think about different people in the Bible, like Jonah, right? Like he was called to go to Nineveh and like tell people about God's wrath on them, right? But he didn't want to. He said that was kind of scary. So he went to someplace else first, like Tarshish or something like that. And then when he got there, he was like, well, I still got to go. God's still calling me. It's still here. So then he eventually went where he was supposed to go and fulfilled his mission in life, right? So, and same with Ruth and Ezra, when she is called to save her people and she's in a position where she can, just by saying something, she can make a huge difference in the life of her people. Like, and she puts her own life on the line to do so. But God is going to call us to do big things in this world. And it's our responsibility to answer that call and to make the difference and serve the purpose that we're supposed to in this life. So he says, never let your quest for balance in life become an excuse for refusing the unique, productive, invading move God directs you to take. Many times the attempt to maintain balance is really just an excuse to remaining lukewarm. Three times the Lord said to Joshua, be strong and courageous. I believe he's saying that to each of us today as well, right? Yes, be strong and courageous. When you choose to live on the offensive, the atmosphere of your life will begin to change. If you don't like the tone of your life, choose to take the offensive position and watch what happens. Taking the offensive starts by making an inward decision that inspires an outward action. When you choose to take the offensive, keep your conflicts impersonal. Fight the issue, not the person. Speak about God within what you can do, not about what others are incapable of doing. You are the only one that there is that's going to take action. You are the only one you can control. You can find that when all of your reasons are defensive, your cause will never be succeeding. A basketball team never takes a shot, that never takes a shot, never wins a game, right? I always tell my third grader, well, they're fourth graders now, oh my goodness, my fourth graders this all the time. My son's a fourth grader. He plays on a basketball team. I help coach them once in a while. And, you know, I always tell them, like, what's the point of this game? Put the ball in the hoop. If you're never going to take a shot, you're never going to win the game. A basketball team that never takes a shot never wins a game. Thinking on the offensive and taking the initiative are the master keys that open the doors of opportunity in your life. Create a habit of taking the initiative and never start your day in neutral. Every morning when your feet hit the floor, think of the offensive. Move forward and take control of your day and of your life. Pulling back and thinking defensively usually enhances the problem. Intimidation always precedes defeat. If you aren't sure which way to go, pray. Talk to someone. Move forward towards a situation in faith. Be like the two fishermen trapped in a storm in the middle of a lake. One turned to the other and said, should we pray or should we row? His wise companion responded, let's do both. Take the offensive position today. I hope that you found something encouraging through this, that this is the first little nugget of the book, and that if you feel compelled to read the rest of it, that you go to the link in the show notes or in the live video here, and that you go get it from Amazon. It's like $11. It's super good book. It's an updated version. It is so good. And I'm excited to keep moving forward in the book and to continue to be inspired myself and to share with you. I share on my social media all the time, Choose to Rise Up here on Facebook and kjpmeyer on Instagram. And I hope that you feel inspired today and that you rise up out of your current situation to live your best life. I am going to be working into January here. I'm starting to take clients for a one-on-one life coaching, working through goal setting, working through problem solving solutions, really whatever you need to get moving and grooving in 2020 and create a vision of life of change and prosperity and good things for you. And I want to be able to support you in that. So if you're interested in some one-on-one coaching with me, I've got 30-minute chunks, an hour time slots. You can buy bulk hours with me and we can schedule things as we go. You can head over to choosetoriseup.com/daily motivation to learn more there. And let's just have a fabulous, fabulous month. Let's have a fabulous week. And remember that pulling back and thinking defensively usually enhances the problem. So if you've got something that you're working on today, if you've got something that you need to work through in life, I want you to take the offensive. I want you to get out of mediocrity. I want you to take the shots that you need to take in order to create the life that you want to live. And I want you to be exciting, innovative, transforming, productive, and moving forward in the way that God created you to move today. All right, everyone, have a fantastic day, and I will see you back here again next time.